So till now we have covered projectile motion from a horizontal surface and projectile motion from a height. The next two topics which we are left with, the first one is projectile motion in an inclined plane. And the second top one is projectile motion or rather relative motion in case of projectiles. In the second topic, we'll deal with collisions in case of projectile motion. So let's begin with projectile motion in an inclined plane. Now suppose we have an inclined plane which is inclined at an angle beta, and we throw a projectile at an angle alpha with the horizontal. In this case we assume the inclined plane to be sufficiently long such that the particle hits the inclined plane, and this is just the range of the particle. If the inclined plane would have been very small, the particle will rather follow the parabolic path and it would drop somewhere here. So we assume the inclined plane to be sufficiently long. Now, to solve questions on projectile motion in an inclined plane, what we do is, rather than taking this and horizontal and vertical as two perpendicular axes, what we do is, we take these two axes as our reference axis. One of the axes is taken along the incline and the other one, y dash, is taken perpendicular to the incline. Now let me ask you something. While we were discussing projectile motion, where the projectile was projected from a horizontal surface, or in case the projectile was projected from some certain height, we knew that if we write y as a function of x, we had got y as x tan theta minus g by 2 x square by u square cos theta. And from this relation, we could say that this was the equation of a parabola. Right. And we said that if the particle was projected at an angle alpha and it reaches on the it follows a parabolic path whose equation was given in terms of this. Now if we are choosing the coordinate axis as x dash and y dash, and we write y dash in terms of fx dash, will it be a parabolic equation? Will this be hold true? Now, to understand this, let's see what are the forces acting on the projectile in this coordinate axis. Now, we see that the only force acting on the projectile is the gravitational force, and the only acceleration of the particle is the downward acceleration due to gravity, which is g. Now, since we have taken this, the reference axis as x dash and y dash, I need to resolve the force, the acceleration g, into two components in x dash and y dash direction. So the value of g in the x dash direction will be will be like this. Now this angle is beta, so this angle will be 90 minus beta, and this angle will be beta. So this component is g cos beta, and this angle is this sin beta. So talking in actual sense, if I assume this direction as positive and this direction as positive, then the value of acceleration due to gravity in the x dash direction is minus sin g sin beta, and in the y dash direction is minus g cos beta. Now I was asking you if y dash in terms of x dash will be a parabolic equation. In this case, y in terms of x was a parabolic equation because there was no force in the, no acceleration in the x direction, and the only acceleration was in the y direction, and so we got y in terms of x as this one, and it was a parabolic equation. Now if we try writing y dash in terms of x dash, we see that there is a acceleration in the x dash direction, and also there is a acceleration in the y dash direction. So that means if I write y dash in terms of x dash, in this case it won't be a parabolic equation. In this reference, if we write y dash in terms of x dash, we won't get an equation of a parabola. Now let's move on to deriving some of the formulas regarding the time of flight of the projectile. In this case, the maximum this distance in the x dash direction covered by the particle, and the maximum height attained by the particle. Now, what is the velocity of the particle, initial velocity of the particle in the x dash direction? That is equal to u. What is this angle? This angle is, this whole angle was alpha, and this angle is beta. So this angle is alpha minus beta. So it will be u cos alpha minus beta. The velocity in the y dash direction will be u sin alpha minus beta. Okay. So at any instant of time t, the velocity v in the x dash direction will be given by u cos alpha minus beta plus a into t. The acceleration in this case in the x dash direction is minus g sin beta into t. The velocity in the y dash direction will be given by t, right? Now the first part asks us to find the time of flight of the particle, the time taken by the particle to reach the inclined plane again. So to find the time of flight of the particle, we'll take the y dash direction is reference. When the particle drops here, the displacement of the particle in the y dash direction is 0. So we can write 0 equal to the initial velocity in the y dash direction, that is y u sin alpha minus beta to t, minus half times g cos beta is the, this is the acceleration in the y direction, which is downward, so we have a negative sign, to t square. From this I get the time of flight as 2u sin alpha minus beta by g cos beta. So in this equation, now if we put beta equals to 0 degree, I see that this, the time of flight becomes 2 sin alpha by g cos only g, that is 2 sin alpha by g, which is this equation of time of flight when the particle is projected from a horizontal surface. So inclined plane is basically you are moving the horizontal surface by some angle beta in the anti-clockwise direction. So this was the equation for time of flight of the particle. Now what is the time taken by the particle to reach this point? Now by intuition we can say that the time taken by the particle to reach this point is half of the time of flight, which is, so it will be equal to u sin alpha minus beta by g cos beta. This should be the case because in the y direction we have one force which is acting in the direction, the downward direction, which is g cos beta. At this point the velocity of the particle in the vertical direction is 0. we only have a velocity in this direction, x dash direction. To find the time taken by the particle to reach this point, what we can do is, we equate the velocity in y direction as 0, and we get, since the velocity in y direction is 0 in this case, we get this as 0 and we will get time of flight as half of this, which is u sin alpha minus beta by g cos beta. So this was how we found the time of flight of the particle when it was projected in an inclined plane. The next part is to find the maximum vertical height taken by the particle, to find h max. Remember, in this case I am saying horizontal and vertical with reference to this axis, this x dash and y dash axis.